All right, welcome to vlog number 7. I'm going to show you guys some highlights of Bushwick Open Studios 2017. I hope you enjoy. Joan and Ashley's work.
It also it stores really easily.
Yeah, and it really takes the paint well.
Yeah.
Really nice.
This contact you by any chance?
She used to be like starting an apartment gallery.
Wow, that's cool.
Nice.
Should, yeah.
Jamie Powell's pieces.
No more pictures of me, though.
No more pictures of you. No more pictures of you.
She posted a picture of me. I was like, oh my God, my
I thought
face.
there was such a cute picture of you. Super great. And you have a show coming up in
March, I think. We
at
haven't set
Arts and
the date
Leisure.
yet. March.
Fantastic. Here's one. John Chaplin.
Emmy award winning Eddie.
Wow, Emmy award winning Eddie. Did you?
Expand?
Painting in a post-factual world with Michael Holden, Bonnie Leibovitz, Joshua Mitchell, Julie Torres, and Albert Weaver. Here we go. See Bonnie's paintings. Here's Bonnie. Julie Torres's work. Nice, really sculptural. Whoa, surprise back here. Nice. There are more Bonnie's that Albert hung in the ceiling. Tell me, how did you come up with the title, Post-Factual World?
Josh had actually come up with the title, and so we had thought about just what's going on with our kind of current situation and painting, and you can kind of create your own reality.
Right. Very cool, very interesting. Very interesting takes on abstract painting for the most part. I mean, Michael's has a little bit of narrative symbolism in it, but it feels very loose.
They're just kind of process paintings. And,
you can see they're really layers and layers. There's a certain luminosity you're getting with the surface quality. And this is Josh's. This show by Becky Kinder at the 449 Fountain.
We'll be having a fun conversation with them. It's like, wow, we're doing this football thing, huh? Now,
look at this painting of clothes.
And then
I spray paint and stencil. And this is painted suspenders with a tattooed silicone premium silicone. Tattooed silicone. Nice. And tarot reading.
Oh.
Hi!
How are you?
Good, how are you? It's a kind of a band from
Multiple
kind of
punk band,
very influential, actually,
singer. Yeah. Multiple different. All right, there you go. So you're doing all of them? And what's your, Sylvia Schwartz is using kind of discarded 3D printing experimentations. in these sculptures. Eddie's work here. Sort of textured collage, mixed media. A large piece here. At Yvette Ziegelblum's studio. What are you calling this series? Really beautiful. Abby Osk's piece that we showed at Trestle Gallery in the Summer Small Workshop. Beautiful, sort of cast sculptural objects photograph, beautiful formal piece. And you can see her other work playing with these kind of tilting, precariously leaning, conjoined pieces. And she is right there. This is a show by Sergio Manino, and let me show you. These are all kind of altar, contemporary altar pieces, furniture design pieces for kind of reflection and centering, and he writes to find lost souls, your own included. Okay, here we are at 119 Ingram at the overhang space. And this show is called Night Vision. And I'm really excited about seeing this piece. This is Medora Fry's piece. You can see the colors change. There I am. What's interesting about this piece is that this is very handmade. This is, I think, liquid graphite. This is Rachel Gorchow's piece. Very nice, Rachel. And Rowan Holly Schindler's work. Okay, here's Emily Selden's studio, right by Overhang. And she was in a show at Trestle Gallery last year. Let me see how she's moving into larger pixel spaces. Graph paper works. I see the domino package doubled. Yeah. That's a sweet piece. So really formalizing these like everyday consumer objects. I'll go, did you start this building, this studio building?
I started this building 15 years ago, but I've been building studios for 20 years. I started in Williamsburg. I was on Richardson Street, and I had an art gallery called Brooklyn Fireproof. And then we expanded out to Bushwick, and we built the film studios across the street, and we are up to 170,000 square feet of creative space.
Wow, amazing. And but you made them this summer. Did you start with a drawing in your sketchbook?
A lot of these actually stem from my wife and I, sort of modeling for the camera, and then I draw from those photographs.
Janie Crimmins, studio Janie.
This work is called Building a Blue Wall, and it's about what is happening in our country right now, and blue is the color of integrity and peace and calm.
And all of these are made out of?
These are all made out of healthcare statements, social justice solicitations, financial statements, anything that relates to how our world is being, how the United States is being assaulted right now.
Alright, so let's just look at some paper sculptures. A bunch of different transformation techniques.